our next lecture. Our next speaker is a gold medalist who has specialized in public health dentistry from Sinhagad Dental College. With more than 13 publications and research journals, Dr. Asavari Shidore has done more than 15 scientific presentations in many national and international journals. She has received about 5 awards and recognitions for her academic and research excellence. Dr. Asavari has attended more than 100 oral health camps in rural and outreach areas and has also worked for improvement of oral health in school children. She is an amazing teacher and a guide for us, and it's my pleasure to introduce you, ma'am, and over to you.
Yes, hello.
Hello, ma'am.
Yeah, you can hear me?
As yes, ma'am.
You can see me? Yeah, I'll just start my presentation.
Yes, ma'am.
Sorry, can you be a little louder?
Okay, right away, sir. Now, is it fine?
Yeah, this is fine.
It's fine. Okay. Is the PPT visible?
Yes, ma'am. The PPT is visible.
Okay. Okay. So a very good afternoon to you all. First of all, thank you, Aditi, for that kind introduction. I hope this
thank
is
you,
not
ma'am.
The stage. Yeah, this is not the stage of you all, and you still have some amount of energy and some more data to grasp in your brains before you have your lunch. So my today's topic is search for research. Okay, so basically the objectives of my session are to impart knowledge and skills regarding literature search and to enable you all to implement these skills while doing your research projects or you doing your short studies as well as your dissertation topics in your near future. So first we are going to address all of these questions. That is why this literature search is so much important. Why do we have to search from every nooks and corners, from every possible source that we have? Okay. So why is it needed? What is it exactly? When do we do it? Where do we do it? And how do we do it? I'll try to explain each of these questions in detail for you all. So before actually starting with my lecture, I want you all to wake up, okay? So now I want you all to guess these movies. Yes, can you guess this movie? Are you all with me? You can put it in the chat box, which is this movie. I think any of the volunteer can just check the, yeah, okay. I am having a few chats. Yes, okay. Only one participant, rest all aren't aware of this movie. Okay, so this movie is basically Bang Bang, right? Then the second one, I'm definitely sure you all must be aware of this one as well. Yes, Dhamaal. Okay, now why is it that I have shown these movies? Is because all the heroes, all the actors in these movies are in search of something, right? They are in search of something which they desire for. So they have already planned out what all their objectives are and what their target is. So they are having their search and proceeding with their search accordingly. Okay, so basically what is literature search? So it is finding about something, it is reading about something, it is thinking about something. And after you have done all of this, it is basically critically analyzing or exactly evaluating what all info you have actually got by finding, by reading, by thinking about a particular idea or about a particular problem or about a particular research question that you have in your mind. So it is a well thought out and organized search for all of the literature which is published on that particular topic. Why organized? That also I'll tell you all. Yes. So why is this literature search important? Is basically it will increase your knowledge on a given topic. It will reveal areas which are not yet researched. Then it will also reveal lacunae in others' research. Then it will offer solution to your problem. It will help in formulating your study design or calculation of your sample size or knowing more about different types of studies that have already been performed. Okay. Now, basically, this you might have heard or you might not have heard, but this is what we call it as hierarchy of evidence. Now, initially, okay, there were studies which were conducted or which were having some low evidence and which were not conducted ethically as well. So if we go from the base of the pyramid, as you can see, there are certain in vitro studies or research which have a low level of evidence or which are considered as low level of evidence. Then comes our animal researches. Then we have particular ideas, editorials, opinions, which are having slightly lesser evidence. As we go up towards top of the pyramid, there are other types of studies and study designs which are having more level of evidence, like the case reports, case series, case control studies, cohort studies. And at the top of the pyramid, you have two things. One is your randomized control trials. You might be very well aware of these. And the second one is, or the topmost is your systematic review and meta-analysis. There is one more about top of this, that is meta-analysis. So this is basically the hierarchy of evidence. Starting from the base of the pyramid, as you proceed towards the top, the level of evidence is going to go on increasing. So obviously, if you choose one particular topic for your research, for example, let's take dental caries. So if you want to find out a particular literature about dental caries, if you search some animal studies and you also search some randomized control trials, then it will obviously be that the randomized control trials or the results, the conclusions, the methodologies which are obtained or done in these randomized control trials will have a more weightage or more level of evidence, higher level of evidence as compared to that of your animal research or as compared to that of your animal studies. Okay, so why is there a need for searching the medical literature? One thing is to learn more about a particular topic, to update yourself, to update of the knowledge, to get more education about that particular topic so that you will become expert in that knowledge and you will be able to apply the same whenever you are in your clinical settings as well. For example, here there are some examples of files or rotary systems which we have long studied back in our BDS days, that is self-adjusting files or new softwares like CAD/CAM or Visilite. So there are newer softwares, newer versions of different electronic systems coming up for our usage in clinical practice. So if you are very well aware of the medical literature, if you go and search it properly, you will become aware of the newer technologies. Yes, next is to determine the current best practice. Okay, as we all know, best practice means there are, suppose if we take an example, there are multiple, there are many toothpaste which are available in the market. Okay, so depending upon the guidelines or depending upon the national guidelines which have been set up, which is the how much is the toothpaste to be used for children? How much is to be used for the adults? What are the different variants? What are their advantages, disadvantages? So to know all of that, to compare all of that, and to utilize this particular information while doing your treatment planning or while doing a treatment for particular patients, it will always be useful. So if at all I have a pedo patient, he has a high caries activity, he needs some kind of orthodontic treatment, then which guideline should I follow? So there is AAPD or there is ADA. There are different associations and different guidelines proposed by them so that you will follow the best possible guideline or treatment which is available for that particular patient. Also, it will help us to provide best possible care for that patient. Okay, now best possible care can be in the form of three things, that is individual clinical expertise, then best external evidence to support it, and patient values and expectations are very well met. So all these three things which are shown in that evidence-based medicine, which is having a common center point, that is, if all these three criteria are fulfilled, you will be able to deliver best possible evidence-based care to your patients. Okay. So if the patient is a known diabetic, he is on medications, then which drugs, which analgesics or which antibiotics you would be prescribing, that would help us if you do a thorough medical literature search or if you do a thorough search and update yourself with the recent advances. Yes. So coming to the next part, that is what all sources we have, from where all we can gain knowledge and in what all different forms is that knowledge available. So there is this systematic searching for various types of studies. Okay, any particular topic you take, you will be having its related information in the form of three sources. You can have either electronic sources, you can have print sources, or you can also have something called as gray literature. Gray literature is something which is not yet published. Okay. So now under electronic sources, we all are aware that there are different databases, there are electronic libraries, and of course you have internet, that is you have your Google Baba, which is always there. Then you have your print sources, that is your maybe guides and all, they have actually gone to the libraries, libraries checked different journals for that particular topic, sat there for that particular amount of time, spent their time there, read the textbooks, journals, that is particularly your hand searching, and taken down the notes. So you can have literature in that form as well. And lastly, you have the gray literature. That is, it can be available in different databases, but most oftenly it is through common peer group, okay, or peer sharing of knowledge or sharing of results, okay, but that is not yet published. But in your peer group, you have that particular knowledge and you have shared it. So that is also useful for you for your particular, for gaining more knowledge about that topic. Then others are different websites. You have different search engines, that is Google, Yahoo, etc. And you also have web directory, that is your Google Scholar. Now we would be seeing a few of these. Yes, so basically how to get started on a literature search. I am clearly audible, right? There is no disturbance. You can all see the slides as well.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So basically how to get started on a literature search. Okay. So first is you will determine your topic. You will determine your area of interest. What are you actually interested on? Then you will conduct your search. Further, you will organize your results and then you will begin writing. Now, to take a Bollywood example of this, if I want, particularly if you ask me, determining my particular topic of interest. Okay, so my topic is supposedly Shah Rukh Khan movies because I am a fan of Shah Rukh Khan. So that would be my topic of interest or my area of interest. Then I will conduct my search. Okay, now conduct my searches. I will go on Google. I will go on Yahoo. I will type Shah Rukh Khan Bollywood movies or whichever new movies of Shah Rukh Khan, okay? Then I will get different results in that, right? I will get his movies right from maybe 1980s till date or whatever may be. So there might be many movies. Then out of that, the ones which I want to see today or maybe after a day or two, that I will separate it out, okay? So in short, that meaning means that I have got a lot of information. Right, I have got multiple movies there, but I am choosing, I am organizing it in the way I want. Okay, so that will particularly yield me my fruit or whatever target I want, that will be achieved ultimately. This is just an example. Okay, now we'll actually proceed to how to determine our particular problem or how to determine our particular question or research question. Now, already you have seen or studied in your morning lectures, that is how to design a research protocol, how to frame a research question. So this is, I think, already talked about once. I'll just repeat it. So PCOS or PCOT format is the one which we usually follow, where P is your patient or population or the problem which you determine. Then I is your intervention or the exposure. That is exactly what you want to do with this patient. Then C is your comparison. That is, if you want to compare a standard drug or a gold standard with a newer drug. So that comparison you have, and then O stands for your outcome. That is exactly what you want to measure. You want to measure the complications, you want to measure the prevalence, you want to measure its morbidity or various other rates, death rate or mortality rate, etc. So that will be your outcome. And ultimately, T or S is your time duration or your study design. So like for how much period of time you want to carry out your study, or what is the study design which you actually want to take up. So all these questions, or by asking all these questions, you will be correctly able to define your research problem. And based on your research problem or your research question, further you will proceed for your literature search. Yes. So coming to these electronic sources, so these are the different databases, okay, which are available. We all know a few of them, that is PubMed, Medline, NLM, that is National Library of Medicine. You have Cochrane, Willis, Scopus, Embase, Science Direct, Google, Google Scholar, and whatnot. There are many. There are different official websites as well, which are there, which will fetch you different type of authenticated data. So, yes. We will see a few of these databases and how to search on those databases as well. I will give a demo of that as well. Okay. Now, again, gray literature, that is your patents and the technical reports which are available. Or as I said, scientific research groups, or you have your peer groups who are working on the similar kind of topic, but they haven't published their literature yet. So the information from that which you get will also attribute to your gray literature. So these are our universities which are having certain information, or they will release certain technical reports. And from that also, you will be gaining and updating your knowledge. And that can also act as one of your literature search part. Yes. Then these are some national and international websites which are also going to provide you with authenticated data on your particular topic of interest. So you all know WHO, World Health Organization, we have this website, WHO.int. Then again, for Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, you have MOHFW. Likewise, there are different websites, and these will give you authenticated data or authenticated literature on that particular subject. Okay, so to start with, different databases or different websites. First is, we all know our Google Baba. So life is like Google. You just need to know what you're searching for. And obviously, whenever you type something in Google, before you type the entire sentence, it will start suggesting you with different options that which one you want to choose. Okay, so if we go with this example, that is if I type oral cancer on Google, as you can see, I will be getting about many results, lakhs of results or lakhs of papers on that particular topic. If I modify my search a little bit, that is if I type PDF oral cancer or PPT on oral cancer, then whatever keywords I'm typing or words I'm typing for my search are going to alter my results. Okay, so here I was getting around many 41, I think, yeah, around that many results, whereas the results or the articles have been precise that only the PDF formats for that oral cancer will be shown in my search if I type it as PDF oral cancer. So this is Google, is just one of the search engines. It will give you data from different areas, like from newspapers or newsletters, editorials, this, that, from news channels as well. But that data is not always authenticated. You have to check and go back to the area where they state that information taken from this. Then you will be able to know whether that particular information is authenticated or not, or is of relevance or not. Okay. So much better version of that is your Google Scholar. So Google Scholar now, as you can see, if you type a particular search word or your search word that is bumpass, suppose I have typed, then you will have different articles. Okay, you will get about, here are about 7,340 articles. Now there are, these are basically the titles of that articles you know of. Further, what we miss is these two parts, okay? That is link to articles that cited this particular work. So this is basically an author which I have typed in. Now this author, ke, these are all the articles which have come up, okay? Now here it is, this particular article was cited by about 366 people. So you will get 366, sorry, articles. You will get 366 articles if you click on that particular link, and you will again find out more related search to that particular author. Next is, you have also link to related articles. So there is another option there. After cited by, there is this related articles. So if you click on that, you will again get the articles which are related to that particular author, as well as, but might be a different topic, or you can also have similar topic of that particular author, but the information is published in some different format. It might not be an article, it might be just an editorial or something. So that was the basic about your Google Scholar. Also, you have certain, you can have certain filters which you can apply, okay, while searching on a particular topic. So if I have again typed as PDF oral cancer, then I can modify by the results by applying various filters. So here, if you can see, any time, that means since what year till what year I want. So if you are conducting, supposing, a systematic review, then obviously you would want your data from this particular year to this particular year. So if that is the case, then you can customize your range, that is from 2000 to 2020. That can also be done. So you will be getting articles related to oral cancer PDF, but only from that particular year duration. Then there is sort by relevance and sort by date. So if you have already chosen your particular date, it will start showing either in descending or ascending order. And also include patents or citations. These are the further filters you can apply. And then you can constrict your results to only that particular parameters which you want to study or which you want to gain from your particular literature search. Okay, now coming to the most common databases that we are using, that is PubMed, Medline, and NLM. Now, initially, Index Medicus was the database which was started in 1879 and it ceased in 2004. Index Medicus was renamed or reframed as Medline in around 1960. But now that has also been ceased in 2004 and you have it as National Library of Medicine, which is the Journal Citation Database, that is NLM, which we commonly know. So it is again a database which has different areas of different areas or topics, articles, and different literature related to various topics. So now if we focus particularly on PubMed, PubMed comprises of more than 32 million citations, and it has got different biomedical literatures from various life science journals, from Medlines. Also, it has got online books. And these citations will also include your full text articles, and full text articles you will get in your PubMed Central. Okay, so again, there is an information overload. You have much more information available, at least more than 32 million citations are there. So now we will just get oriented with the basic search in PubMed as to how to go about and how to explore your PubMed database. Because if you have to play with that database as much as possible, you will explore things there. You will type out different keywords. I'll show that to you. That much ease you will have in searching that particular articles or searching particular data about your topic of interest. So first thing is you have to understand the PubMed's homepage structure, manage your results using different types of display. Display meaning, as I had shown, filters. There are different filters or alerts which we can apply onto, and that will help us to get our particular topic of interest only. Then we can save our search strategies so that in future also, if we want to check and get back that which particular search we had done, then that also is available as a facility. Then link to full text articles and other sources you will have, and you can use filters as well as special queries. Okay, so PMC, that is PubMed Central, it was launched in 2000. It is basically a free full text archive of biomedical and life sciences journal literature. So I'll just show you the demonstration. I am audible clearly, right? And you can all see my screen as well?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, yes, first we'll start with... Yeah. So, whenever you will type in Google PubMed, just PubMed, this screen will appear. Okay. So now this is basically the home page of PubMed, that is pubmed.gov. Now you have this login option here. If you go here in your login option, this is basically your dashboard, which will appear. You can create your account here. Now this account will be your NCBI account. Now NCBI is nothing, but it is National Center for Biotechnology Information. So if you create your account here, you can very well keep your saved searches. Then you can see your recent history. You can also have your publications here. So if you haven't created an account here, you can create one. Now, since I have already created one, otherwise there will be a sign up option. Yeah, this is a sign up option which you will have. That is new here, sign up option. But as of now, I will log in with the account just to show you a few things of the author dashboard. Okay, so I have logged in. This is my account. Then you will be seeing this author dashboard. You will have publications, account settings, and logout. So we'll just quickly go to the author dashboard. So this is my NCBI account. Now I can search through this as well, but I'll just show you what all features it has. That is search NCBI databases. Now search in PubMed. You have different options or categories here as well. Search for books if you want to go for that particular topic. Then you have you have this mesh database also, then NCLM catalog also. So whichever is of particular use to you, you can apply that particular category and then search with your particular topic. So supposedly oral cancer, and if I press search, it will redirect me to the home page of PubMed. I'll show that as well, but this is just the author login dashboard which we have. Then you have this bibliography which you can manage later when you will start creating items, when you will save your searches. Ultimately, it will appear in your recent activity as well. Then this is the saved searches section. You have your collections and again different filters which can be applied. So you can very well create your account here, save the data and save your searches, which is of particular interest for you all. Now, right now I'm signing out of this. I will just show you how to go back to our particular, 1 second. Okay, so this is again my homepage, which I have. So here, if I type oral cancer, supposedly, and if I go on search, So you can see now there are different articles. There are about 14,07,612 results which I have got, which are related to oral cancer. Okay. Now you have to modify your results because you don't want all of these articles, and it is not actually possible or feasible for you to go through all of these results. So now we have to apply particular filters which are there on this side. So this is basically results by year. So from 1940, it is showing me results. So I will come down to around, say, okay, 2005. So again, my results will get reduced and very much precise to my particular topic, to my particular interest. Then this is full text, which I have selected. So again, the results have narrowed down. Then if I specifically want only randomized control trials which are conducted on my particular topic, that is on oral cancer, then again, if you can see the number, it has reduced to around 3,000 results. Furthermore, if I want to apply filter, the publication date. But we have already selected our date from 2005 to 2021. So if you still want to restrict it to only 1 year publication, then you will have only 149 results or 149 articles which are suitable or which are there for your particular subject, that is oral cancer, from 2020 to 2021. Also, you have additional filters option. So if you see, there is article type, you can select newspapers or newspaper articles. Then you can select a type of journal. That is, if you want to search only in dental journals, you can very well apply that filter. And obviously, the results will get modified accordingly. So you have this dental journal category. I'm choosing that as well. So now see, if you can see, there are only 10 results related to oral cancer, which have been published in 1 year, which are specifically published in dental journals, which are randomized control trials, and which are within only that which are full text and within that 1 year time frame or time period. So this will exactly yield the precise information which you want for your particular topic, that is oral cancer. Is this all clear? Have you all understood this part of your search, basic search? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, okay. I hope everyone is with me. Okay, then... yeah, we'll quickly go to this next page. So this page is your PMC or PubMed Central. As I had stated, it is a free full text archive of biomedical and life sciences journal literature at USNIH, that is National Library of Medicine or National Institutes of Health. Now here also you have a similar type of taskbar. Only thing, you have much more features if you go to your PMC webpage or homepage. Now, firstly, I will show you how to go to quick links. So you have, see, this resources option is there, or you have a drop-down box there where you have different categories there. Now, if I go to literature category, you can see I have bookshelves, e-utilities, journals in NCBI database, mesh database, PubMed, PubMed Central. So if I choose one of this, supposedly I'm choosing journals in NCBI database, then I can directly type out one journal name, supposedly clinical journal of clinical periodontology. So if I type that, then okay, so I have information about that particular journal too. If you want to search which journal is actually PubMed indexed or not, you can go through this NLM catalog as well, or NLM catalog from NCBI database as well. Next, you can also explore other options from this resources category, that is through the literature part. You can go to bookshelf. Again, you can type one particular keyword, whichever you want. Suppose dental caries. And again, search. Yes. So again, there are around 328 books which are available, okay, which are related to dental caries. But again, by applying these filters, which you see on the left side, you will be able to exactly get the only those books or only the recent knowledge if you want to get, then only 1 year publication. If I click it as a filter, then I'll be able to check. There will be only 15 books. So I'll be going through only the recent knowledge or the books which have been published in an year or so. Okay, so this was about the bookshelf. Then you also have, okay, this how-to section. So again, if you go to the literature part here, right now I'm restricting my search only to the literature part, but later if you want to explore the other aspects as well, you can very well go back and explore. So you have these quick links as well from these resources part, which we had checked. The similar links are available here as well. That is, you can see the bookshelf, then journals in NCBI database, then mesh database, handbook also you have, as well as help manual and various other searches. Okay. Also, you have this option of choosing whether all databases or only in PMC database or only in mesh browser of your PubMed. So if we go to the PMC database now, if I want to search about dental caries in school children. So again, I'm just entering this search and let's see what all options are coming. Yeah. So again, if you see, I have got around 12,523 articles which are related to dental caries in school children. So again, I will choose filters here. I will choose open access article only. Then I will choose for over period of 1 year only. Then further also there are search fields available. That is, I can search only by abstract, by mesh terms, by body, etc., etc. There are other various options, many options available by which you can search and add this type of additional filter as well. This is one more filter, that is research funder. If you want to customize your search by using that filter, you can very well do that as well. And you have this additional filters option as well, where you again have text availability, search fields, etc., etc. So here, if you see, now I have got around 1,295 articles which are related to dental caries in school children, and also which are open access and which are having 1 year publication date within 1 year. So this is the basic search which we all do, or we always do, or we have known. Now we'll go to a little bit advanced search. Now before going to this search, I'll just tell you something about our Boolean logic or Boolean operator. Yeah. Okay. So yes, there is something called as Boolean operator. Now, this Boolean logic was developed as an algebraic system of logic, which is widely used nowadays in computers and electronic systems, including your database searching. So there are three Boolean operators. There is OR, there is AND, and there is NOT. It is by using these Boolean operators, your search is going to be very much simple and also powerful. Powerful is nothing but you will get exact that data or exact those keywords which you want to enter your search, and you will get only those relevant articles related to that particular topic or those keywords only. So now first we see AND. So both the terms which are included in any of the results will yield you the results. We'll see the examples of this as well. So I have searched in PubMed as tobacco and oral cancer. So and is the keyword boolean operator which I have used between two keywords or between two mesh terms. Next is your or. So either tobacco or oral cancer, both the terms would be present in the results which I obtain. So tobacco or oral cancer, and I will get the results. So I will get those articles which have the term tobacco, which have the term cancer, which has the term tobacco as well as cancer. And lastly, you have not. So it will obviously exclude any results which are not containing that particular term. So, okay. Then yes, this is tobacco and not oral cancer. So now, if we put these Boolean operators together, then it will help us. I'll just tell you concept wise. So if you want to create a Boolean search, I have taken this example, that is vitamin C helpful in treating the flu? So we have framed these 2-3 concepts, that is influenza, vitamin C, treatment and helpfulness. And these are nothing but the synonyms, okay, of that particular keywords like vitamin C, ascorbic acid, ascorbate, treatment, therapy, management, etc. So with that same word, you can have different synonyms which can be used for your Boolean search. So make your or statements one per concept, that is influenza or flu or orthomyxovirus, vitamin C or ascorbic acid or ascorbate. Likewise, then put and between each of the or statements. So influenza or flu and vitamin C or ascorbic acid. Okay, so you are combining the two things. You are putting and in between the two or statements. Okay, so we'll just quickly see in that advanced search field. I know you all are hungry, but just spare a few more minutes. So I had gone to this advanced search section from this dashboard. So in the advanced search section, here you have all fields again, meaning you are searching in all of the fields and not just abstract or not just mesh heading. Now I'll type oral cancer. And I want and is the Boolean operator which I'm using. And I will type your tobacco. You can apply multiple Boolean operators as well. But as of now, if we search oral cancer and tobacco, and we will again yield a few results. And you can again apply filters in this so that you will have different searches which you want to do as per your convenience. Now, if you see, there is an excellent option of history as well. So whatever searches I have done are seen along with the timings also here. Okay, so whatever Boolean operators I have used or I have previously searched are available in your history section or history part as well. Okay. Yes. And consider any not statements you might want to add. So if you want to add, that is tobacco and oral cancer, not smoking or not lung cancer, then that can also be one of your key search or Boolean search. Tobacco and oral cancer, not lung cancer. Okay, but not is not that oftenly used. Yes, now going beyond basic Boolean, that is you have something called as field searching, you have controlled vocabulary and specialty features. So field searching is that all fields or specific field search you can have, that I had already shown you. You have all fields ka section where you had seen abstract or mesh terms or mesh headings, and you can choose one specific from that and it will yield you that particular result only. Now, these are some PubMed field tags. Quickly take a snapshot of this because you can search by using these PubMed field tags as well. That is, it will help you It will help you in your restricted search, that is, you will have specific author search, specific publication date search. You can enter the year, or you can enter title, author, and whatnot, depending upon the particular field tags which are available. I'll just show you, take a snapshot of this. Yeah. So now, yeah, in your search column or in your search bar, this is the author name which I have entered, that is Johns. This is AU. You have to enter these brackets and you have to enter this field tag and your Boolean operator, that is and 2005, that is your date of publication, which is DP. So you can use multiple field tags which are available, and you can search that particular topics which you want with the help of your Boolean operators as well. Okay, then there is something called as mesh, or you must have all heard mesh terms or mesh browsers. So you have something called as medical subject headings. Now, this is a controlled vocabulary, which is a set of terms which have already been determined, and every term will represent a single concept, and only one term can be used for that particular concept. So this is again the mesh browser which you will be having. Okay, you can search different mesh terms on this mesh browser. Also, if you want to find out whether certain keywords are mesh terms or no, for example, whether dental caries, oral cancer, periodontitis, all of these are keywords, whether they are mesh terms or no, or whether they are there in the mesh browser or no, can also be determined using this particular mesh browser. The link for the same is also given. So whenever you are giving your maybe journal clubs, or whenever you are searching for articles, when you see keywords, you can go back to the mesh browser and search whether that particular keyword is a mesh term or no by using this particular browser. Okay, so mesh is basically how many words could you think of for the idea of cancer. So you have different synonyms. You have tumor, malignancy, neoplasm, sarcoma. These are all different synonyms, or that mesh synonyms which can be used for your searches. Then there are articles in database, that is, one particular article states breast tumors in young women. The second one states surgery for prostate cancer. The third one states is as diagnosing melanoma. So these are types of cancers, but different terms are used in the titles. So if you will use only one particular term, then you might not yield the articles which you have used another term. For example, if you just search oral cancer, you might not get articles which have stated oral cancer as neoplasm or neoplastic tumor or something of that sort. So it is very important to correctly choose those mesh terms or keywords while doing your search, and to get particular knowledge of it. Then you have something called as truncation. Now, truncation is basically, remember, these two symbols, okay, are used as wild card symbols. They are known as wild card symbols. So if you directly enter your word and then enter this particular symbol, you will get different single and plural versions of the same word which are being used. So therapy, therapies, therapeutics, these are singular and plural versions of that same word, but they can be used in different articles. So if you just put therapy in your search, it might not give you articles which has therapies and therapeutics as the word for your search. So again, you can use these wildcard symbols. Remember these two symbols, the asterisk and this symbol. So it will help you to get appropriate searches accordingly while you are doing your literature search. Or you can also combine them in an OR relationship, that is OR relationship, or your Boolean search. Okay, and the last one thing is your phrase searching. So if you want to search by using particular phrase, that is fever of unknown origin, then such common phrases are also there, or you can also use these phrases for your literature search, and most of the databases will accept this as a phrase in your quotes as well. Lastly, you can save your search strategies. That is whatever search or whatever AND or Boolean searches you have done. I had already shown you that you have a recent activity or a recent history of the same. So that can also be saved in your search board, and that will appear in your author dashboard if you have created an account there. Then there are these other databases. You all know Cochrane, then Wiley Online Library. You can browse here by your subject. That is, you will go to your dental or dentistry or any other medicine if you want to search about. Then you have Science Direct. You have Hindavi Publishing Corporation. Also, the Indian NLM. That is your National Medical Library. Then you have Clinical Trials Registry, that is CTRI India. You have this particular website as well, where you can go in with your searches. That is, if you want to search for specific trials, it will give you different options. That is, it will have study design, trial phase, recruitment status, state, district, etc., etc. You can choose by one or two specific options, which are relevant to your particular search or relevant for your particular topic, and search through this website as well, that is CTRI. So concluding, some tips for your literature search: while making notes, make a habit of writing your reference, or you can very well download your reference as well. Don't just copy paste, or don't just control C and control V like we always do. Read it, understand it, and also keep a note of the online references on what date or what time you have accessed, because whenever you are writing research protocols at that particular point of time, you will have to write the references in that particular format, that is Vancouver style, or whenever an online reference is being accessed on, you will be writing that particular part as well. Then copy your link for future reference. Use bookmarks, then also keep on finding cross references. That is also going to give you further knowledge about that particular subject. So finally, doing a literature search, firstly, understand your question, understand what topic you want to search about, organize your thoughts about the same, identify different perspectives about it, then identify whatever search engines you have, because you might not have access to all the databases. So you will have to use your college IDs, your college passwords for the same, or you can also gain access through your friends' passwords from other universities. So you will have the search engines or access to your search engines or databases. Then you will run a search. Then you will refine and review your search. That is, you will have so much data. You will have so much data available. You will refine it. You will review it again, that which particular data you want. Then you will limit and combine your keywords. You will apply different filters like access full text or publication years. Then finally, you will keep a record of the same, produce its bibliography, and write up whatever findings you have got or whatever findings you have received, and ultimately present these findings. So I thank you all for listening patiently, even though you're hungry. And I thank the P-Value and IADS for letting me in and sharing my knowledge on this particular topic. Also, special thanks to Dr. Vineet Vinay and the P-Value team for organizing this webinar quite well. Thank you all for having me.